Hello everyone, I am Dr. Sukhada, consultant radiologist based in Pune currently. This e-presentation is regarding the article published in the International Journal of Science and Research in March 2018. It is regarding an interesting case of Santorini seal which we came across in Siam Hospital. Firstly, embryologically, pancreas develops from two outpouchings, that is dorsal and ventral pancreatic buds of the endodermal lining of the foregut. Duct of dorsal pancreas is known as duct of Santorini, whereas the ventral pancreatic duct is known as duct of Virson. Dorsal pancreas develops faster than the ventral pancreas. Also, the ventral pancreas rotates towards the dorsal pancreas and finally joins the dorsal pancreas. So, in the final anatomic arrangement, the dorsal annulus forms major part of the pancreas, that is head, body and tail, whereas the ventral annulus forms minor part, mainly the uncinate process of the pancreas. In most cases, the pancreatic duct from the dorsal pancreas fuses with that of ventral pancreas to form the main pancreatic duct. So the Santorini duct in the head region distal to the fusion remains as a small channel and opens at the minor papilla. So entire pancreatic secretions and biliary secretions gain access to the duodenum by way of ventral pancreatic duct at the major papilla. Due to this unique pattern of development, many types of congenital pancreatic parenchyma as well as ductal anomalies can occur. Though these anomalies are relatively uncommon, they are often discovered as an incidental finding in asymptomatic patients. Some of the anomalies may lead to various clinical symptoms such as recurrent abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting, etc. Pancreatism represents a variation in pancreatic ductal anatomy which results from failure of fusion of the dorsal and ventral pancreatic annulus. In majority of cases of pancreatism, it is characterized by the dorsal pancreatic duct, that is main duct and the Santorini duct directly entering the minor papilla with no communication with the ventral duct. Thus, the dorsal pancreatic duct drains most of the pancreatic glandular parenchyma via minor papilla. Now, Santorini seal refers to the cystic dilatation of the dorsal pancreatic duct, that is duct of Santorini, just proximal to the minor papilla. It was first described in 1994 by Eisen et al. Exact pathophysiology is not known, however, both congenital as well as acquired etiology is proposed. Since majority of the cases are encountered in adults or elderly people, it is proposed that the structural changes might contribute to the acquired mucosal weakness, facilitating the formation of Santorini seal. Some cases are also found in children, leading to assumption of congenital role. There is a relative stenosis at the minor papilla, causing high intraductal pressure or back pressure, and it may result in pancreatitis. Santorini seal has been most commonly associated with pancreas division, which is known as SWPD. When it occurs without pancreas division, it is known as SWOPP or Santorini seal without pancreas division pathophysiology. However, most of these cases are accompanied by a dominant dorsal pancreatic duct in which the caliber of the dorsal pancreatic duct is wider than that of ventral duct, which has similar pathophysiology to that of pancreas division. SWOPP is a rare condition and is most commonly found in patients suffering from chronic pancreatitis and is considered as acquired condition. The case described in this article is of a 45-year-old female who complained of mild generalized abdominal pain. She did not have any significant prior medical or surgical history. Her general as well as abdominal examination findings were within normal limits. Even the blood parameters were normal. Serum amylase level was done, which was also normal. Ultrasound was performed as the routine first-line investigation. There was dilatation of main as well as the accessory pancreatic ducts. On the first go, it resembled a pseudocyst. However, on careful examination, it was clear that it was the duct which was dilated. Now, MDCT or multidirectional CT was performed. It also confirmed our findings. The main as well as accessory pancreatic duct were both dilated. Dorsal duct was equal or slightly more prominent than the ventral duct. Now, since the patient was symptomatic and ductal dilatation was significant, we could not ignore it. So, MRCP was performed. We hope that there might be some congenital anomaly which is resulting in these symptoms. But to our surprise, MRCP revealed perfectly normal ductal anatomy. Due to persistent symptoms, decision of surgical intervention was taken. Lateral pancreatic jejunostomy with Roux-en-Y anastomosis was done. The patient tolerated the procedure quite well and there was resolution of abdominal pain. So this was a unique case of Santorini seal along with Vercingo seal, which was not associated with any anatomic anomaly or previous episodes of pancreatitis, and in which the patient benefited from surgical management. Thank you for showing interest in this case. We had referred to these articles.